Employee onboarding can quickly become a nightmare if the process isn't laid out just right. There are too many tasks to complete and too many people from different departments involved. But you can get rid of the complexity by designing a workflow. Let's see how to create one right now. Hi, Matt Barron, product specialist at InvGate. With InvGate Service Desk, you can quickly build a help desk for HR and IT and facilities and design an onboarding workflow to automate that process. And the best part is that you don't need to create it from scratch. You can use our pre-built employee onboarding workflow template. Before we get started, you can always grab a free trial of our software at try.invgate.com and follow along. You'll also find a link in the description. Automating the onboarding of new hires is a smart move to ensure your new employees have everything that they need on the first day, stay in compliance with organizational and industry policies, and improve your employees' experience in the company. The basic steps of the process are already designed for you in our template. Let's see what it looks like. To get there, we log in as an admin, go to settings, and click on workflows. There are several workflows in here, but the template that we're looking for is called Employee Onboarding. And you can see the process here. Now, anytime that you're working in our workflow editor, you can double click on any one of these nodes to get into the details of it. And if you need to add things, you can always use the steps menu over here. So, for instance, I might look at the form to begin the process and decide I don't want specific fields. Like maybe I don't have an employment type. Maybe we have no part-time employees. I can take that off the template by just simply deleting it. If we don't require a birth certificate, I can remove that. And I can change some of these other terms. If I don't like the term line manager, I can change that. I can add additional fields. Maybe I need to add in a specific dropdown. For that, I'll choose a list. And we'll call it location. In this list dropdown, we're just gonna have a few locations. First, our Minneapolis office, then our Buenos Aires office, and we'll add our Mexico City office. Great. Now when people are filling out the form, they're gonna need to select one of those locations. We're gonna go back to the flow now, and we're gonna inspect the rest of these steps here to make sure that they're set up right. HR approval. Looks like it's good. The only thing I'm gonna turn off is this expiration because we give them more than 2 days and we're not actually gonna track the SLA, so we can stop pausing it. Now I'm gonna look at the HR tasks. Yeah, I see we're missing the I-9 form, so I'm gonna add that here. I'll just add in a new task to collect a new employee's I-9 form. Perfect. I'll go back to the workflow. We're gonna check out these IT tasks just to make sure that this is correct. Oh, actually this is IT information, I should say. So custom email, any username specific requests that they have, and equipment to be assigned. I'm just gonna pull up this configuration item and just see what we're doing for equipment. That looks good. Now I'm gonna check out this Azure AD account. This is doing a web service call, so this is an API that's pushing the correct information to our Active Directory. And this all looks good. It's got our name, nickname, surname, given name, account enabled, password, force change password. Good stuff. Looks like that's pretty pre-built. And then we go to the IT tasks. And it looks like we're just missing one task here to pull new laptop from inventory. And we're just gonna move that up to the top. And something that I do here specifically is that not all these tasks are required. So I'm just gonna add this optional toggle. And I'm gonna add in some due dates here. I want the laptop to be pulled from inventory within 1 day of this request being made. And then all of the agent software and BitLocker all needs to be done within 2 days. So that gives us 48 hours from the form being submitted, and then delivering the equipment to the user, we only get a 5-day notice. So I'm gonna make sure that happens within 4 days, and this looks good. Next, we've got an approval to confirm the equipment. So this goes to their line manager and tells them specifically which machine we've given them. Kind of a nice little feature, but it's not something that we require in our organization. So I'm just gonna delete that one. And then we're gonna choose which path remains active. Of course, accepted is the one that we want because it's the happy path. And we're just gonna make sure that this asset gets assigned properly. So this is a task to assign the owner status and location to that specific asset. And then I'm just gonna check out this email to the line manager real quick. Onboarding process. I'm just gonna change some verbiage here. We're glad. Happy to inform you that so-and-so's onboarding process is complete. Thank you so much. I can double check these variables by just double clicking on them. First name, last name. This is going to the line manager, first name, and last name. Good stuff. Nothing to attach. The last thing I need to do is, since I deleted one step, I just need to make sure that all of my flows are correct. It looks like they are. I don't see any errors, and it's already saved. At this point, I can go through and deploy my changes. So to do this, I just click on the deploy button here. And it's gonna just give me a quick warning to make sure that I want to actually do this, because it is gonna save this workflow forever and apply to any new hires that are happening. And this workflow hasn't been assigned to a category yet. So this is something that I can go under and assign it to my employee onboarding request. And once it's assigned, I click on assign now. And now anyone that uses that employee onboarding request will get this form and go through this workflow. And this is just one aspect of InvGate Service Desk that's designed to make automation easy for everyone. For more on this topic, subscribe to our YouTube channel or discover our solutions by signing up for a trial at try.invgate.com. I hope you enjoyed this video and hope to see you again soon.